Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick, still down here in the great state of South Carolina. As long as the Lord wills, I'll be here by His grace. Brothers and sisters, praise God Almighty. I just want to tell you that we had no damage there in the orphanages. We have two orphanages, and no damage at any of the feeding areas where we do the feedings. Praise God, you know, brothers and sisters. Those of you who don't know, we feed over 800 kids a week. The website, I have and a Facebook group that I have. I put out pictures almost daily, and then I've done videos on my channel. It's hard to search for videos, though, the way, of course, they keep trying to make YouTube more difficult and less user-friendly. Of course, they don't want people to communicate. I mean, YouTube and the internet is one of the greatest gifts of free speech and exchange of ideas, and of course, it's dangerous to the man. They don't like it, so let's enjoy it while we've got it, and pray by the grace of God it'll still be here until the rapture happens, brothers and sisters, before it all turns over just to pure propaganda from the man, like the mainstream media and television is today. You know, it's a miracle of God that the internet that we have, brothers and sisters. I ask you to thank the Lord for it and think about it, how, you know, we have the internet, which is one of the greatest gifts we could have to exchange free ideas amongst each other, which is we've never had that in the history of man. You know, this, you know, we can communicate with people all around the world without, you know, the individually instead of the mainstream media. So praise God for that. Brothers and sisters, I also want to praise the Lord for I've had many people contacting me with, praise reports all the time of who we've prayed for. I prayed for, and you guys prayed for, even the anointing oil. I've had about 16 people message me, personally about being healed from the anointing oil and using it, and many more that were comments. So praise the Lord for that. Also, let's give God the praise. You know, it's the prayer of faith that heals the sick, and the anointing oil that the Lord told me to make is just a point of contact, brothers and sisters. According to James chapter 5, it says, any sick among you, call for the elders of the church, anointing them with oil in the name of the Lord, and the prayer of faith shall heal the sick. So, brothers and sisters, the elders, myself, and like Brother Sid has been coming here and praying with me over the oil once a week. And then all of you guys who I prayed with the oil right here. I don't have the oil, another bottle of oil sitting beside me right now. Several times, you know, I brought out some new oil and we prayed right here in the video. You know, maybe 100 people or 2 or 3, 4, 5. I mean, I don't know how many. I would say there was 1,500 views of a video. Maybe 500 people, by the grace of God, prayed. That is awesome. You can imagine you got 500 people praying for you. I mean, the Bible says one can put 1,000 to flight, two can put 10,000. So, you know, how much more can 500 people put to flight? You know, you just keep adding zeros. That's what they call exponentially, you know. Keep adding zeros to it, brothers and sisters. Even as Reinhard Bunke has said, you know, he is a zero and the Lord is the one. So he and the Lord is already 10, you know, and one more zero, it's 100. And then another zero, we're all zeros. And then Jesus is the one. So together, you know, it's multiplied. Anyway, brothers and sisters, I also want to tell you the particular one. I specifically asked people to pray for a brother Grant, who's in Missouri, I believe in St. Louis area, greater St. Louis area. His sister is the owner of this house, Sister Mary, her name, Mary. And I asked you guys specifically to pray, and she and I prayed. She took some anointing oil there. You know, she anointed herself and she prayed for him and had been praying for him and believing for him to be healed. Now, she had received a word from the Lord from at least two different reliable people that said that the Lord's plan was for him to go home to be with the Lord. He had leukemia and pretty bad. And, you know, it was in pretty bad shape. And he was going through all these treatments and all this stuff and looking for a bone marrow transplant to come up, brothers and sisters. But even I, you know, I prayed with her and told her that it was in my spirit that the Lord's plan was for him to go home. But, of course, prayer changes everything. You know, Moses prayed and the Lord, it says he repented, but God, you know, already knew what he was going to do. But when God wanted to destroy the children of Israel, because they had made the golden calves, and he told Moses, hey, I'll make a nation out of you. And then, you know, Moses interceded as a type of Christ. He interceded for the people, you know, as a shadow and a type of Christ and said, but, you know, God, you said, you know, that you're going to make a mighty nation out of these people. And You know, the whole world will say, hey, you know, God, you know, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob brought these people out here and then killed them all. I mean, you know, God have mercy and grace on these people. And so God, it says God repented of what he is, you know, what he wanted to do. And as I said, God, repent means a change of direction, a change of direction. In Hebrew, repent means to change direction. In Greek, in the Greek culture, the word repent means to change your mind. And so that's where people get confused about becoming saved. And they say, they have a mental assent and say, hey, you know, I've decided I'm going to stop, you know, looking at porno on the internet. I've decided I'm going to stop committing adultery. I've decided I'm going to stop taking the Lord's name in vain. Whatever. But it's a mental agreement. So when we get saved, we make that mental agreement that day in the Greek way of repentance. We turn our mind to the Word of God. We turn our mind toward Jesus. But in the Hebrew way, and also we should literally repent, means to turn from our sin. So we turn to another direction. So repentance is making, first you make a mental check. Hey, God says, you know, the Lord has convicted me. The Lord has convicted me about, you know, having unforgiveness in my heart towards somebody. You know, I mean, we repent as we're convicted. And so the Lord is always leading us and guiding us and convicting us by His Spirit to greater and greater levels of repentance. And we are at the level of maturity in the Lord at the last time we were obedient and repented and turned from our sin. We made a mental check in the Greek way and repented and said, hey, I'm going to forgive this person. And then in the Hebrew way, we act on that and we literally forgive them. Even if it means sometimes we call them and say, hey, you know, I love you, everything's cool. Or we forgive them and then, you know, we don't hold any more grudge against them and we act on it as if there's nothing, you know, no problem in between us. So, you know, we act out that forgiveness and literally make a change in our actions. Now, that's the Hebrew meaning. So we're to do both, brothers and sisters. It starts with the mental and then the physical. So anyway, we prayed, brothers and sisters, and this sister Mary truly believed that her brother would be healed. And I, you know, I'd given her a little bit of a word from the Lord that, you know, that she was, when she went out there, you know, because I was one of the people who had heard that he was going to go on home, as I said. And the Lord told me to tell her, hey, you're blessed and highly favored. You know, and I told her that. And I texted her when she was at the airport or when she got out there to Missouri at the airport there that, you know, hey, basically saying, hey, you're going to ask the Lord and you're going to press in by faith. The Lord's going to honor you, even though this was his original plan. You know, so praise God. Her faith, brothers and sisters. You know, and then when I told her we're praying for her, I mentioned it in the video, those all things built her faith and helped her. That's why, brothers and sisters, we need each other. You know, there's many times people will discourage you. You know, when you deal with religious people, I probably never talked about this. Many of you guys, like me, you know, you have relatives who are religious people. You know, they're all bound up in their doctrines and not in the Word of God. In other words, let's just be specific. They're cessationists. They believe that God is not the same today as He was yesterday. They don't believe the Bible verse that says He's the same yesterday, today, and forever. They don't believe even in, you know, what we rapture people call dispensationalism. And we are in the dispensation of the Holy Spirit in the church age. We are in the church age. The church age did not end when the apostles died. The book of Acts is still being written. You know, it just trails off. You know, the book of Acts never ends. We are still in the book of Acts. We are still in the age of the church where the Holy Spirit is operating. God is operating through His Holy Spirit. Jesus is the high priest seated at the right hand of the Father until God would make all of His enemies, the Father would make all of His enemies His footstools, a.k.a. the second coming of Christ. So, actually at the rapture, it'll begin to change at the rapture when the Lord will convert His position and change to a new dispensation from which now, when He was on earth, He was Emmanuel, God with us. And then, when He sent down the Holy Spirit, He is God in us. The Lord is in us. And He is our high priest, the Lord Jesus Christ, the high priest, ever make intercession for us, seated at the right hand of the Father. And then He will return as King of kings and Lord of lords. But in the meantime, He's going to get His church and He's going to be the bridegroom. And we are going to be the bride. We will be at the judgment seat of Christ, the bema seat of Christ, they call it in Greek, the bema seat. Like when Pontius Pilate sat in judgment over Jesus, he sat in the place called the pavement of the bema seat. When they tried to persecute Paul, you know, and then one time they let him go. And, you know, Jesus said, told him, you know, I've got many people in this city. the head of the Jews tried to persecute him for converting the Jewish people there, and then it ended up that that guy got beat up by the other Jews, and Paul was let go, and he that was the time he was not beat. And when he was there at that magistrate's office, he was before the Bema seat. He was before a judgment seat, a judge. So we, as Christians, will appear at the judgment seat of Christ, and then we have the marriage supper of the Lamb, praise God, and then the Lord will return as King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Anyway, I wanted to read a text to you, brothers and sisters, and talk to you about something here. From 2 Kings chapter 6. Now, this is something the Lord's been talking to me about several days, and I'm just beginning to unpack what the Lord is showing me. And that's how the Lord will do me. He'll give me something, he'll want me to study it, and then as I speak about it, it'll start coming out, then unpacking, and go over it, and the Lord will give me all these different, you know, the Bible is like an onion, so we dig through the layers and dig through the layers and go deeper, or you can say you go higher into higher dimensions of the Word, or you can say deeper, you know, into the things of God. Either way, you know, this is, a way of describing it's not in the natural mind where we are today. You know, God is taking us to a new level and illuminating our mind. And illuminating our mind to a higher level, a deeper level in Him. Also, brothers and sisters, before I forget, I want to think about it, that, as the Lord had told me, we would build another orphanage here at the next year, at the end of this year, going into next year. And, a great deal for land just came up, brothers and sisters, for only $500 an acre, or what would that be, like $1,200 per hectare. For all of you who are not, from the U.S., from our system of measurement, about 500 per acre. So this is about 20 acres. So it's about $10,000, brothers and sisters, full of coconut trees that we could purchase. And brothers and sisters, the area is about to become they're making a new state in the Philippines, and this is going to be a new capital area of that state where this land is. It's currently farmland full of coconut trees that we can harvest to support the orphanage. And then we can even build an orphanage there. And then in 10, 20, 30 years or whatever, if the Lord doesn't return for us, the value of this land is going to be in the new capital that they're just making. They haven't even started yet. It's already been proclaimed this will be this new capital city. You know, so one day that land will be very valuable that we could, if the Lord willing, the ministry can, because it'll be gone, and maybe by that time, that land can be sold, and then that money could buy land, a lot more land in a rural area. The value of the land will go up. So it's a great investment. We have the coconut tree harvest that will pay for the land for how many, will return the cost of the land within like 7 or 8 years. And then secondly, on this 8 hectares or 20 acres, we can build an orphanage also, brothers and sisters, for the next 20, 30 years or my lifetime, whatever that may be, or the return of the Lord, it doesn't matter. You know, we're doing all we can to finish the race for the Lord. Plant a new orphanage. All of our orphanages, brothers and sisters, are also churches for the local people. And we do feedings through the orphanages too, and vacation Bible schools and all those other things. And we're really planting a church where the orphanages are also. That's the whole purpose. You know, the little child will lead them. That's the commission of Joshua's ministry. The little children will lead them to the Lord. So let me go into this video as I usually make a separate report video. The Lord is just leading me to plop this right in the middle. Okay, 2 Kings chapter 6, starting at verse 8. The king of Syria warred against Israel and took counsel with his servants, saying, "In such and such a place shall be my camp." And the man of God sent unto the king of Israel, saying, this is Elisha, "Beware that thou pass not such a place, for thither the Syrians are come down." And the king of Israel sent to the place which the man of God told him and warned him of it, and saved himself there not once nor twice. Therefore the heart of the king of Syria was sore troubled of these things, and he called his servants and said unto them, "Will ye not show me which of us is for the king of Israel?" And one of his servants said, "None, my lord, O king, but Elisha," that's not Elijah, this was the disciple of Elisha. Elijah was a guy called Elisha. Two different people. Elisha was a servant to Elijah. Then he became the prophet and got a double portion of Elijah's anointing. Elijah is probably the most famous prophet in the Bible. But Elisha had a double portion. Therefore, the heart of the king was troubled. Oh, we already said that. Verse 12. And one of his servants said, "None, my lord, O king. Elisha, the prophet that is in Israel, tell the king of Israel the words of thou speakest in thy bedchamber." And he said, "Go and spy where he is, that I send and fetch him." He was told, saying, "Behold, he's in Dothan." I wanted to do a different message, which I will do later on, but the Lord is just, unpacking this first section. I need to make a separate video and come back further on with this text what the Lord is telling me. So, you know, praise the Lord, brothers and sisters. You know, we're supposed to enter His gates with thanksgiving in our heart and enter His court with praise. That's why the Lord has been leading me to sing, because in my flesh I can't sing. But, you know, when we sing, the Holy Spirit comes up and on us, upon us, you know. The Holy Spirit is within us. You know, all born-again Christians have the seal of the Holy Spirit in their heart. And then when we're baptized in the Holy Spirit, we have this river of living water, John chapter 7, that's coming out of us. So if you want to study about that, just in the type of that or understanding, John chapter 4, we have that wellspring of living water in us, like Jesus told the woman at the well, the Samaritan woman. And then John chapter 7, we have that river of living water flowing out of us. And as we would begin to worship the Lord and praise Him, even call on His name, and start saying His name, Jesus, you know, it releases the Holy Spirit. The Lord Jesus Christ be praised. You know, it releases the anointing, you know. So I want to talk about, this text. But first, the Lord is just leading me, you know, to worship Him. So I will, because the Lord told me to, you know. So praise His name. Let's praise His name. Praise God. Let's have a praise break. Hallelujah. Hallowed be Your name, Lord. Hallelujah. Thy kingdom come, Thy will be done in us as it is in heaven. Hallelujah. Give us this day, Lord, our daily bread. Hallelujah, Lord. We honor You. We praise You. Blessed assurance. Hallelujah. Jesus is mine. Blessed assurance. Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine. Heir of salvation, purchased of God. Born of His Spirit, washed in His blood. This is my story, this is my song. I'm praising my Savior all the day long. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Perfect submission, all is at rest. I and my Savior am happy and blessed. Watching and waiting, looking above, filled with His Spirit, washed in His blood. This is my story, this is my song. Hallelujah. Praising my Savior all the day long. Hallelujah. Praise His name. Hallelujah. You got to praise His name. Hallelujah. Because when you begin to praise Him, that's when you get the breakthrough. That's when God begins to answer your prayers. Just like Sister, I'll use her name, Mary. She began to praise the Lord and worship the Lord. Hallelujah. And we prayed in agreement. She's been praying. Other people are praying. We use the anointing oil, all those things. All those things came together, and the prayer of faith has healed the sick. Praise God Almighty, through whom all blessings flow. Praise Father, all ye creatures here below. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord on high. The name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run into Him, and they are healed and saved and delivered and made free by the blood of the Lamb. I've been redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise His name. Hallowed be His name. Hallelujah. Thy kingdom come, Thy will be done in each of us as it is in heaven. Hallelujah. Praise You, Jesus. Glory to God in the highest. Hallelujah. Praise His name. That's another video I need to make about legalistic people. You know, the whole world knows about the virgin birth of the Messiah because of the date, the made-up date of the birth of Jesus. Hallelujah. The whole world knows who Jesus is because of that holiday made up by people of this made-up date of what we call Christmas. The whole world knows. Let's celebrate the Lord. Hallelujah. Let's celebrate the virgin birth. Let's celebrate the resurrection of our Lord. Celebrate the presence of the Lord, for He is worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. So let's look at this text. Praise God Almighty. Hallelujah. What does it say? It says that the king of Syria, everything he tried to do, the king of Israel already knew, because the prophet of God, Elisha, was hearing what he was saying in his heart, in his whispering amongst his people, and God was revealing it to him, and he was telling the king of Israel. So it's like this, brothers and sisters. Let's apply this to ourselves. The Bible says God will do nothing without first revealing it to His sons, the prophets. So God will speak to us and tell us and lead us and guide us by His Spirit into all truth and righteousness. Hallelujah. So the enemy, like Syria, I can do a whole hour-long teaching on this. The enemy has plans. As Paul said, we're not ignorant of the devil's devices. Peter said, the devil is like a roaring lion, walking about seeking whom he may devour. Well, you know, and I would say he may not devour me, because Christ is within me. It's not me, but Christ that liveth within me. Hallelujah. How can Satan eat a dead man? I'm already dead. He can eat this flesh, try to eat this flesh, but it's dead. It's dead. It's dead. I'm a dead man walking. It's not I live, but Christ that it is in me, Paul said, that is living. It is the resurrection power of God. I am resurrected with Christ, as the Bible tells us. When we're baptized, we're raised up and resurrected with the Lord. Hallelujah. The Spirit, my spirit, is walking with the Spirit of God. As Jesus said, the Spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak. Therefore, let's crucify our flesh. Let's put our flesh under our feet. Hallelujah. And tread it under. Tread it under. Because we're not ignorant of Satan's devices. God tells us and leads us by His Spirit, in His Word, and by His Spirit. We hear it whispered in our ears what Satan's plans are. I will tell you this. If you've been a Christian any time, I want to tell you this. If you have any experience as a Christian in trying to serve the Lord, you know that the devil has the same old pattern he always tries to hook you with. Whether if it's looking at pornography for many men, if it's looking at, you know, and then, of course, women in the natural, you know, lusting after. And some of you, it's lusting after the same sex. Strange flesh. There's a brother who, you know, is struggling with, that I, at least one brother that I talked to, or two, that have talked to me that are struggling with homosexuality. You know, it's lust. It's lust. Either way, it's lust. One is just lust, you know, in the, of men, of the opposite sex. But anyway, sin is sin. And lust is lust. Brothers and sisters. And then there's some of you, you know, you always have that wicked person that's always trying to draw you in, brothers and sisters. I deal with the same thing. Almost, you know, and it comes in seasons too. You know, I have a season where like almost every day I have one person who will comment on my videos, attacking me, talking junk to me, talking down to me, you know, insulting me, sometimes cussing me out. Sometimes it's atheist. Sometimes it's a Judaizer. Sometimes it's a once saved, always saved person. Sometimes it's a person that hates the rapture and they want to attack. Their motive is something else, but you know, they go on a personal attack. Have about one a day, but it goes in a season. I have a whole bunch of them, like a cluster, and then I won't have none for a month, and then I'll have a cluster of them. You know, and that's just, I can see the signature of the devil all over that. And then, but God is so good, brothers. I'm using this as an example. God is so good. When I get one troll like that, there'll be three or four people that emailed me in the day. Every one troll I get, three or four people will email me and say, "Brother Patrick, you don't know how much you impacted my life. You know, I got rededicated my life watching your videos. I got healed when you prayed on your video. You gave me a word and it was true. Praise God." You know, those kind of things. And of course, brothers and sisters, we're all human. Like I said, we try to crucify our flesh. I try to crucify my flesh. But you know, you have to resist that when someone's insulting you. And then when someone is encouraging you, it is a blessing to your flesh. It is a blessing to you. That, hey, even though there's, you know, and that's my second message out of this text, you know, there's more with us than against us. And that's really the message that I wanted to make from this text. If you read on in there, we see there's more with us than against us. You know, so praise God for that. That's what the Lord's been showing me personally and to share with you. If you read on in that text, 2 Kings chapter 6, I guess the Lord is leading me there. I will continue with it because the Lord just brought it up in my spirit. I was going to make a separate video. You know me, I always say I'm going to make a short video. I always end up making a long video. You know, I don't have a vehicle this week, and Brother Sid is coming to take me to the grocery store. So I'm trying to, you know, just a FYI personal information there. So I'm trying to, hurry up and do the video. Because we already planned it, and Brother Sid's nice enough to give me a ride to the grocery store, so I don't want to make him wait, brothers and sisters, even though I know he will. You know, there's no doubt about that, because he's a brother in the Lord. True brothers and sisters, you know, we're not easily offended. You know, as it says in 1 Corinthians chapter 13, you know, love is long-suffering, love is all those things that love are, 1 Corinthians chapter 13, read that if you want to read about what love is, you know. And it's long-suffering. So they go to they go in this text to arrest Elisha, the king of Assyria, which I was talking about. He's mad. He wants to try to kill Elisha. Verse 15, and when the servant of the man of God was risen early, so Elisha had an assistant, no name here, and gone forth, behold, a host compassed the city, both with horses and chariots, and his servant said unto him, alas, my master, he's talking to Elisha, how shall we do, or what are we going to do? And he answered, fear not, for there be with us are more than they that be with them. And Elisha prayed and said, Lord, I pray thee, open his eyes that he may see. And the Lord opened the eyes of the young man, and he saw, and behold, the mountain was full of horses and chariots of fire round about Elisha. And when they came down to him, Elisha prayed unto the Lord and said, smite this people, I pray thee, with blindness. And he smote them with blindness, according to the word of Elisha. And Elijah said unto them, this is not the way, neither is this city. Follow me, and I will bring you to the man with whom you seek. And he led them to Samaria. So it goes on that Elisha actually took this army to the king of Israel, and they were blinded and handed them over. But the point that the Lord's been talking to me about the last 2 days, and I'm just scratching the surface. There is more with us than against us. Now, in this text, the young man's eyes opened. He saw the chariots of fire. He saw the angels of the Lord, you know, those angels that defended Elisha because he was a prophet, and those angels that defended the nation of Israel. You know, he was seeing that. The servant saw that. And that's why Elisha told him, before the young man could even see, hey, there's more with us than they have. We have more than they have. So we have more angels with us than the devil has. We have more brothers and sisters who will die for us and love us and minister to us than the devil has people trying to attack us. The Bible says God will not let you, you know, get into a position that you cannot escape, brothers and sisters. I'm just putting it in modern English. God will not let you be tempted beyond what you can handle. Now, we all sin, we all have trouble, we all get mad, we all get discouraged, and I've been meaning to talk about and counsel you guys. And, you know, I'm just touching on this, and you know me, it's all connected. There's lots of people, 90% of the people watching me rededicated their lives or got saved in 2011, came back to the Lord. Even people on YouTube who are big on YouTube, they just came to the Lord, they came back to the Lord after years and years of being a backslider or a non-believer, they got saved. And because they thought the rapture was going to be then, and it has not been. And the Lord is telling me to warn them. I need to make a separate video. There's many of you that are going to go back to sleep. And I say, woe unto you, those who sleep. Because those who sleep in the night, it says. But we are not children of the night, but children of the day. So that day should not overtake us as a thief. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5. 1 Thessalonians chapter 4 talks about the rapture. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5 tells us what to do in light of the fact that the Lord is about to descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel and the trumpet of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise, and those of us who are alive shall be raptured, shall be caught up, shall be harpozoed, you know, to meet the Lord in the air. So there's many of you who are in danger of going back to sleep. And the Lord wants me to warn you that and caution you that. And like I said, I need to make a separate, complete video about that. I'm just, you know, and I'm just unpacking all these things that the Lord has just been dropping on me the last 2 days, brothers and sisters. So, you know, there's lots of you who are disappointed when I said, Lord, show me that my wife and I would have another child and it would be a girl. And the Lord has been showing me that for years. And, you know, that. So I don't know what to tell you, but that's what the Lord showed me. And, of course, the rapture is not based on what I do. And some people are messing with me. Are you trying to give a word from the Lord that the rapture is not going to be, until after your wife has a baby and it's 18 months old like I saw in my dream? No. Don't depend on what the dream that the Lord gave me about. The Lord is going to, no man knows the day or the hour when the Lord's coming. That's the point. So you need to, you know, live like the Lord's coming tomorrow, but you also need to plan and live your life also to go forward and do the will of God for 20 more years, 30 more years, the rest of your life. You know? So, that's why those people's dreams and all this stuff never move me. It never moves me, even what the Lord shows me. Because with the Lord from eternity, it's like, the Lord's coming back now. The Lord's coming back now. You know, now from eternity. But I do believe the signs are here. You know, I don't get into all that. But it doesn't even matter. The point is that you have to run the race of endurance. Don't be easily moved and running to and fro on YouTube looking for people's dreams. As a matter of fact, someone just trolled me. The last troll I had told me. They said, I'm not going to watch your videos anymore because I'm only looking for videos that's telling me what's going on today in the news and when's the rapture, you know, like when's the tribulation and rapture. Your video is just like beating people over the head with the gospel. And I don't want to hear that. I just want to hear about current events and how it relates to the Bible. And I told that person, number one, I make my videos as the Lord leads me, not to please any people. So if the Lord tells me to make a video about the rapture, I'm going to make that. If the Lord tells me to make a video about the gospel, I'm going to make that. Discipleship, whatnot, and what have you, and whatever the Lord wants me to say. I'm preaching for a one-man audience. That's the Lord Jesus Christ, to please Him only. And I don't care what anybody thinks. And I've said that many times. I've said it 100 times. And I don't. I'm here to please the Lord, and that's it. I don't care if I got 1 million viewers, or just like Noah, I get on the ark with only his family. It doesn't matter to me. The measure of success is, did I say, who, what, when, where, why, and how the Lord's will be done, and that's it. I mean, that's where the flesh is crucified. Not to please man, to be a people pleaser. A man pleaser, as the King James calls it. And number two, those people who are running to and fro, as I always warn and caution, those are the very people who are probably not going in the rapture. They're shallow, immature, not sanctified, not following the Lord, but running to and fro. And just every little wind of doctrine and every little, they just change their whole life. And, you know, there's people that sell their stuff and go stand out in the yard. I mean, there's people that's losing their mind because of somebody on YouTube's dream. We don't do that. The Lord is steadfast. God is not the God of confusion. He's not the author of confusion, but of peace. God is steadfast and unmovable. Hallelujah. Blessed assurance. That's why I'm singing that song. The Lord has just reminded me. That's why He gave me that song to sing. You know, I was just, you know, because the Lord's been having me sing a song every time. And I was like, well, Lord, I guess maybe I'll sing again. The Lord said, I want you to sing Blessed Assurance. Now I know why. Not about once saved, always saved, which is what the real people, that's what they meant when they wrote it, I do believe, as far as I know. But it's blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory to mine, you know. It's a blessed assurance. You know, like the song, Leaning on the Everlasting Arms, you know. Safe and secure from all alarms. You know, we need to rest in the Lord. He is the blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Hallelujah. Watching and waiting. Hallelujah. You know, we got to praise Him all day long and bless Him. Brothers and sisters, I need to go. Praise God through whom all blessings flow. Praise God for the praise reports. I praise God. I know God is going to make a way. As the Lord has spoken to me about building more orphanages, I know that it's all going to come to pass. I ask you guys to pray about it. Help me pray about it. I know the Lord's going to do it. He already told me. Pray about it, that, you know, that the whole, this deal for this land is an excellent deal. You know, I know it's from the Lord. It's in there's like 3 or 4 places I've been praying about. This is one of those places where the Lord has led me. You know, this is an area we need to build an orphanage. Besides those other places, I believe we'll build them in the other place too. And now I'm sitting there saying, oh, well, the rapture's going to be. I'm not, no, we work, we occupy till the Lord comes. We keep on working. You know, I'm working on a building. It's a sure foundation. That's another song. Working on a building, it's a sure foundation. I'm holding up the bloodstained battle for my Lord. I never get tired of working on a building for my Lord. I'm going to heaven to get my reward. Hallelujah. Praise His name. Hallelujah. Let's keep working while the sun is shining. As they say, make hay while the sun is shining. Let's keep pushing, working, believing, praising all day, all the day long. Hallelujah. Let's keep busy till the day is done. It's not over till Jesus says, come up here. Till Jesus says, come home. Rings the dinner bell. Ding, 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 ding. I can make a video out of all those things. Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. God bless you guys. May the Lord be with you always. May His peace shine upon you. May He give you rest in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah.